Hey, what's up guys? This is James Hurst and welcome back to another video training tutorial. Today I'm going to be talking about Zapier and how to troubleshoot what is appearing to be a broken Zap. You might get an email saying, hey, this Zap, it aired out, you know, there's a problem, you know. First of all, like, don't freak out. Like, you know, if something's not quite right, if an email address isn't there, or if it's if it's not a valid email address, then yeah, it's going to error out, because a lot of systems, you know, they can't accept a badly formed email address. So for example, if I come over here, this Zap, I'm going to look at the Zap in question, and over here to the right hand side, I'm going to click the drop down and click task history. Okay. This is going to show me each and every time this Zap has run. And so then if you want to go into the details of that Zap, you go ahead and just click on it there. And what you'll see is, you know, what is the data that's coming out of this first Zap here. So on the data out here, you can see, okay, I've got this person's name, it's pending, 485, and then below you have the product, right? So now that I'm looking at this, I'm realizing that, hey, this looks definitely like a tier two thing, and probably the email used to go right there. So if I actually look at the error message, it says the email is not a valid email, okay? So back in the day, ClickFunnels used to give us the email address of our tier two people, but they just said, hey, you know what, we don't really, you know, we don't want people abusing that, we don't people, it's just not necessary to for the tracking purposes, so we're just not going to give you their email address. So they made a change to backpack, and tier two emails no longer come through, which means that you you probably want to filter out the tier twos in the Zapier step. So that's a filter step. And I've actually already done a training on that. I will show you what it looks like here. I'm gonna put it right here if you want to look for it. It's called CF Follow Up Pro Paid Training Optional Zapier Tier 2 Setup. Okay. So check that out. I'll walk you through exactly how to do that. But yeah, as far as like diagnosing and troubleshooting Zapier here, you're just gonna see what data was coming out, right? You're going to look at what data, what was the error that was returned, and then as far as the data coming in, and then try to say, yeah, like, why would it be giving the error? Well, this one is easy. There was no email. Of course the email wasn't working because there wasn't one, okay? And so then you might be able to prevent that situation from happening in the future by filtering it out, or maybe it's just a bad email and you could say, well, hey, you know what? I'm just going to take a loss on that one. And you know, it's okay for Zaps to error out. I mean, if you're not always getting in a perfect email every time, you know, if your form accepts, you know, a junk email, then it's just going to error out, and you live with that. So, so yeah, hopefully that helps. That's how you troubleshoot a Zap. Sometimes it's okay to leave it errored out like that and just fine. Or sometimes you might need to make a tweak, so it doesn't error out in the future. Other times, you know, if you're mapping, let's say, if your mapping was wrong, you said, hey, the email is going to be going into this field, and you saw, oh, actually the email is now going into this other field. Well, then you would need to go back. You would need to go back to the step here, and you would need to change the mapping between the Google sheet and where you said where it needed to look for the email address. So those are some of the common things you might run into. Hopefully that was helpful, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks.